What's up, mortals? It's TC Crew here, and before we get into today's video, there's something I'd like to say. I'd like to let you all know that we have a merch store. Some of the items in it are only available for a limited amount of time, so if you're interested, go into the description and check it out. Each purchase helps us make more content. Secondly, if this video hits 500 likes by the end of the week, we will continue this What If. Thirdly, if you guys didn't know, only 41.3% of you guys are subscribed to us. So please hit that subscribe button and click the bell icon. Now with that out of the way, let's get into the story. If you haven't watched parts 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, watch those parts first before this one, or even if you need a refresher, there will be a link in the description below of all the parts. Now with that out of the way, let's get into the video. It was the next day of school, and Midoriya was walking through the halls of UA, but encountered some stairs while trying to get to class. He couldn't help but think about what happened the day prior, when he pushed his body to his absolute limit, then broke even further. This got Midoriya thinking that he could infinitely increase his power if he wanted to. He mumbled and brought on more stairs as he stood before the door of Class 1A. He opened it only to be met with a barrage of questions.
"Hey Midoriya!" shouted Kirishima. "That was awesome yesterday! When were you going to tell us about your new ultimate move? It looks so manly! Everyone get back to your seats. Mr. Aizawa will be here."
Ida protested, but the volume of the room was too high for anyone to hear him.
"You were really scary. You looked like you wanted to kill him, but you were so cool!"
Mina shouted as her excitement level skyrocketed when she remembered him fighting.
"Get to your seats, everyone! We don't want to..."
Ida pleaded this time while he chopped his hands repeatedly and still no one would listen.
"Please guys,"
Midoriya said.
"I just want to get to my seat."
The group of students that huddled around the door gave way to Midoriya as he closed the door behind him. It seemed as though they were slightly frightened if he got mad again. He went to sit on his seat, however, the huddle still followed and continued to blast him with questions. Ida still demanded that everyone return to their seats.
"I'll answer all your questions after class. Mr. Aizawa is gonna kick our butts if you guys don't get back to your seats."
Midoriya implored, but his plea fell on deaf ears. The door shuffled slightly and everyone then rushed to their seats, leaving Ida dumbfounded as he was the only student standing up.
"Ida, if I catch you being the last one to their seats again, I'll give the role of class rep to someone more fitting."
Ida went to his seat, mumbling something while Uraraka tried to cheer him up.
"Due to the complications that happened after the fight yesterday,"
he stared towards Midoriya,
"we weren't able to talk about the work studies and what it truly means to be in one. And since he insisted on coming back, Mirio Togata is going to explain everything to you, and then you can ask him questions."
Everyone turned their attention to the door. The smiling blonde that was Mirio walked in with a sling around his right arm and a small plaster on his temple. He stood next to Aizawa as he slipped into his yellow sleeping bag.
"Hello again! How's everyone doing?"
Mirio asked, in his always cheery mood. Everyone would have responded as cheerily as he did, but most remembered how Mirio destroyed each and every one of them with just one punch, each. No one responded, and he received a few glares.
"Okay, let me just say sorry first. I'm not very good with words. I was feeling very energetic and thought maybe showing you what doing a work study can do for you. What do you guys think of my quirk? Is it strong?"
"Yeah, it's too strong!"
shouted Sero as he flailed his arms around.
"Yeah, it's not fair! My quirk is nothing compared to that!"
retorted Hakugare.
"Yeah, how can you phase through things and warp? Do you have two quirks like Todoroki does?"
Mina questioned him. A small bead of sweat could be seen on Mirio's forehead as he tried to answer the question without giving away his secret.
Nope, just one,"
Mirio answered as he showed his best poker face.
"Just one,"
Midoriya whispered, making sure no one could hear him as he chuckled slightly to himself.
"My quirk name is Permeation, and the warping was..."
Mirio waited for someone to answer, but he just continued himself.
"You guessed it, simply an alternate application of that power. When it activates, I can go through anything, no sweat. That includes solid ground."
"So that was you falling through the floor of the gym?"
Uraraka queried.
"Yeah, that's right. And whenever I release my quirk while falling, something super strange happens. Apparently things with mass can't overlap. That's called physics, and so I get repelled upward. The ground spits me out and I fly into the air.
That's how my warp works. By changing the angle based on the direction of my body or pose I'm holding, I can aim for where I get repelled to. Sounds like a buggy video game.
Mina replied.
You could say that.
Mirio laughed.
So you can avoid all attacks and move wherever you like in an instant? It is a really strong quirk.
Suyu said. Most of the students agreed with her comment.
No, I made it into a strong quirk. When my quirk activates, my lungs can't take in oxygen. In the same way, vibrations go through my eardrums and light goes through my retinas. I can go through everything. That means I can't feel anything. I just fall even while I have mass. That's all it is. Does that make sense? That's why, if I want to go through a wall, I activate everything but one leg, then I release the other leg and land on it. I then activate my other leg and go through. Even for a simple task like that, I have to put a lot of thought into them.
Mirio explained.
If that were me, I'd mess it up every time.
Kaminari said.
Yeah, and I wouldn't be able to move if I can't feel a thing.
Mineta added.
That's right, I was always behind. In order to get to the top of this quirk, I had to start working on my mentality and increase the options I could use to win in a fight. I started to work on predictions and think faster than anyone else. Becoming tricky was my new number one asset. I gained experience through training and fighting in a work study. When a pro invites us to a work study, we're not guests. We're treated as one of the sidekicks and as pros. That's really scary. Pros risk their lives and see death frequently. But through those scary and painful things, all of them are first-rate experiences you wouldn't be able to have in a school. I changed my experience into power and took the top spot. That's why it's something you should do first years, even if you're afraid.
Mirio ended.
Why, even though he said he wasn't good with words, he sounds like a pro hero. I can't wait to see who I'll be working with.
Yao Yorozu said very excitedly.
I hope I get to work for a hero that kicks every villain's butt.
Uraraka shouted as she threw a fist in the air.
I hope I get a hot babe.
Mineta said in a creepy tone, only to be smacked by Suyu's tongue. Everyone started to talk until a cold shiver hit their spines. They looked towards the front of the class, and Aizawa had activated his quirk as he showed his death glare. The students all returned to complete silence.
You kids better make the right decision. Just like the internships, I know quite a few third years who still regret their decisions. Class dismissed.
Aizawa said, again in his cold and emotionless voice. Before we get back into the story, I would like to say that we've got a second channel called Anime Deep Dive. Anime Deep Dive goes over the hard facts of the anime presented. Now, in case you guys didn't know, we have a third channel called We the Celestial Naruto What If. We the Celestial Naruto What If mainly focuses on our Naruto What If series. If you are interested in content like this, please go check the description below or click the eye icon in the top right corner. Now, with that out of the way, let's get back into the story. It was now the end of the day, and most of the students had an idea or a recommendation from another student. Kurishima contacted Amajiki while Suyu and Uraraka asked Hato if they could join her work study. Midori had an idea but wasn't sure whether he should have moved forward with it or not. He made his choice and ran down the corridors towards the 30th floor, and before he got there, he ran into Mirio Togata.
Oh, hello there, trouble kid. Why are you here?
Mirio asked in his cheery mood.
I want to do my internship with Mr. Night Eye. I want to learn and grow alongside you. And I want to see what I can do to improve, what training you do for that, and how different you are to me. Like that, I can see what it means to become number one at UA.
Midoriya said this with so much conviction that Mirio had no other response other than,
I'll see what I can do.
Midoriya had a glimmer in his eyes, wanting to be the best so he could become the next symbol of peace. They said their goodbyes to each other, and Midoriya ran home. He knew that it would take a lot of hard work, and so for a week, his quirk has changed a lot over his lifetime. From giving him a tail to turning into a giant ape, and now being able to power up and fight was the next step in his quirk's evolution. So, after training on his transformation, it started to become less and less strenuous the more he did it. It was as though his ceiling wasn't broken, just elevated. He now knew there was more to his power-up than he first thought. However, one day he was training near Dogaba Beach, clearing some of the trash as well as doing endurance, stamina, strength, and conditioning workouts in the water. This time there wasn't as much rubbish, but there were quite a few big pieces. He decided it would be better to reduce the bigger pieces by smashing them flat from above. He was successful with the first two big pieces. However, when he jumped above the third one, he slipped on his landing on the fridge. He started falling and panicked slightly. He activated his base mode form and did everything he could to prevent injuries. He closed his eyes at the last second, waiting for the impact of sand in his face, but noticed a sense of weightlessness. He opened his eyes and he was floating slightly off the ground. He looked towards his feet and they were also off the ground. Shocked with this, he tried standing straight and to float back up towards the top of the fridge. As soon as he thought about it, he started going back up and landed softly on the fridge. Midoriya then practiced his new flying technique, along with his Super Saiyan form. It was the end of the week, and after school, Mirio was in the corridors of the first year floor. The bell had just rang, and Class 1A were leaving their homeroom. Midoriya was the last one out with Ida and Uraraka. He saw Mirio at the door and told him to meet him outside the school gates. Both walked ahead as Mirio walked in. "So I've talked with Mr. Nighteye, and he said that he'll accept your offer if you're up to his standards. Tomorrow I'm going to the agency for my patrol. You should come with me after school. Like that, he can see for certain whether you've got potential in his eyes," Mirio told his junior. "Just a small hint. He is really strict, and so maybe because of his serious image, he holds humor in high regard, so if you're able to make him laugh, you'll be accepted in seconds." Midoriya felt a cold shiver as he knew he was never a funny person. He definitely thought he was doomed, but he couldn't just give up. He walked with Mirio for a few minutes until they both reached the school gates. They agreed to meet at the gates the next day as Mirio turned back to go to school. Midoriya and his friends walked to the station and then split up as each made their way home. Midoriya told his mom that he would be arriving later tomorrow as he had a very important and very busy day. He trained for a small bit with weights, had a shower, ate, and went to bed, happily anticipating what was to come. Thank you all for watching the video to the end. Now there are a few more things that I'd like to go over before the video ends. On behalf of We the Celestials, I'd like to thank the writer of this video and the editors for this video. Their details will be in the description. If you're a voice actor, editor, or writer, or you're interested in becoming one of those, go to the Discord that is in the description of this video and hit up the head of one of those areas. We're always looking for members to join us. That's it from us for today's video, so thank you all for watching, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you're interested, and hit that like button if you like the video. Until next time, peace out, mortals, have a fantastic day.